it turns out I love gathering statistics on what I've been reading. I don't like doing it throughout the year as I go and like doing it as I'm reading books, but it turns out I love sitting down in December and working out all the nitty-gritty details. And I didn't realize how much I loved it until I sat down to plan this video and was like, oh my goodness, this is so much fun, working out all these random statistics and details, averages per month, why not this other random tiny statistic? So here we are, and I have quite a lot to cover. So I'm calling part one of this video, how much did I read? And the answer is, I read 40 books in 2020, which is a total of 12,608 pages. So my average number of pages per book was 315 pages. The longest book I read this year was Empire of Storms by Sarah J Maas, which was 689 pages. And the shortest one was volume 3 of Saga by Brian K Vaughan and Fiona Staples, which was 144 pages. So here is the breakdown of exactly how many books I read within each page range. I didn't read any under 100 pages this year, but the vast majority were between like the 100 and 300 page benchmark, with only a few, six books in total, being over 500 pages. And I do feel like I kind of saw that coming before I gathered this statistic. I was really aware this year of like how intimidating longer books can be, so I do think I made more of an effort to read shorter books to also like knock them off my TBR shelf if possible and move them onto my main shelves. But also I read quite a lot of graphic novels, which we'll get to in a later statistic, but they tend to have lower page counts. So this whole section, not too surprising so far. Okay, so here is a breakdown of exactly how many pages I read per month. I say exactly, not entirely accurate because obviously like I did do some reading in November, but here it says I did zero. What I did for this graph was basically get all the books I finished per month and then just put those page numbers in. So my two like best months for reading this year were April and July, which coincidentally were when I did the Owls Readathon and the Reading Rush, which both did force me to read quite a lot more than I'm used to, so that's not very surprising for me. And also where this drops off towards the end of the year, that's because I got a new job in September and I just had like a lot less time to read. But generally I did read a lot more than 2019. I think I read about three times as much in terms of page count. And so as one of my New Year's resolutions was just read more, I think I've definitely nailed that. Okay, section two of this is, did I like what I read? And the answer is generally yes. My average rating for books this year was 3.5. And for me, 3 stars is like good. It means like solid good, I liked it. And then 4 stars is I really liked it. So that is like a very decent rating. So the more exact breakdown of star ratings was I gave no books 1 star. I did DNF one book, which I'm not counting in these statistics. And I probably would have given that 1 star if I finished it. But that's the reason I DNF'd it. So I gave 8 books 2 stars and 10 books got 3 stars from me. And then 18 books got 4 stars from me and 4 got 5 stars. So not too many 5-star reads actually, and 2 of those were rereads. And here are my average ratings per month. Again, this graph isn't perfect because I did read very different amounts throughout the year per different month, but this is on average what it turned out to be. Okay, section 3 is where were the books from? So of the 40 books I read, 11 were rereads and 29 were like new to me books. And of those 29 new to me books, 6 were borrowed from other people, 15 of them had been on my TBR shelf for less than 6 months, and then 8 had been on my TBR shelf for over 6 months. The book I owned the longest before finally reading it this year was, I think, Ghostwritten by David Mitchell, which I'm pretty sure I had on my shelves since 2015. And the book I read, which I owned for like the shortest amount of time before reading it this year, was The Turn of the Key by Ruth Ware, which I think I had for like 1 month before I read it. So that is an unusually quick turnaround for me. And then finally, in 2020, I bought and then read in the same year 9 books. So I wasn't doing too terribly at like getting through books that I'd owned for ages and not read, but I wasn't doing a fantastic job of that either. So section 4, who did I read from? This is all about the authors. So this year I read from 49 different authors, and that sounds like a lot, but pretty much all the anomalies in this category can come down to the anthology book I read, A Phoenix First Must Burn, which had 16 different authors. So that does kind of skew the statistics in this section a little bit, but I'm going to try and get on top of that. So of those 49 authors that I read from this year, 35 of them were actually new to me, and then 14 were authors I had read from before. Also, I should say, I'm counting like the artists of graphic novels as authors as well in this category. So I was curious about whether I liked the books by returning authors or new authors more. So I worked out an average rating for them all. And actually there wasn't much in it. Returning authors got an average score of 3.3 out of 5 stars, and then new authors had 3.6. So it's like a slight difference there, but I don't think I can read too much into that. In terms of a gender breakdown, 38 of the authors I read from were female, 9 were male, and then 2 were non-binary or gender non-conforming. And then in terms of race and ethnicity, I read from 23 white authors and 26 authors of colour, which sounds much more impressive than it was until you remember that I read the anthology, which had 16 different black authors in it. So like a large chunk of that number is just from that one book. So a more accurate way for me to look at this would be to say that I read 25 books by white authors and then 15 had at least one author of colour. And finally, in terms of nationality, actually the vast majority of people I read from were American, which I didn't actually expect. So 30 of the authors were from the USA and then only 8 were British. And then I had 3 from Canada, 2 from Japan, and then 1 from each of Sweden, Haiti, Nigeria, Germany, Russia, and Australia. Okay, last section, and this one is called What Did I Read? I read 31 paperback books, 8 hardback and 1 ebook, which does not surprise me. I'm very much a paperback kind of person. I read 24 like ordinary books, like prose books, 14 graphic novels, 1 comic and 1 anthology. For age range, 32 of the 40 were adult books and 8 I would count as YA. This stat doesn't really surprise me that much. I do think I read more adult than YA, but I did think it would be slightly more even. So, don't know what was going on this year. 34 of the books I read were fiction and 6 were non-fiction. And then for a more specific genre breakdown, I made this chart. So the genre I read the most of was fantasy, this does not surprise me, followed by sci-fi, mystery thrillers, and then memoirs. This one was the biggest surprise to me. Like, I know I read 5, that's like a massive amount, but I don't read that much nonfiction. And it wasn't like I sat down at the beginning of this year and was like, I'm gonna read more memoirs. I just accidentally kept reading them and really enjoyed most of them. And to prove that, here is a little breakdown of average ratings per genre. The first half of this graph is like a lot more accurate, I would say, because I read more of those genres, and then like the last 3, I read like 1 or 2 of books in those genres, so that bit doesn't really mean anything. So in terms of when the books I read were published, I read 5 books which were published in 2020, which is not a lot compared to other people. I'm really not up on the new release game. 6 were published in 2019 and 7 in 2018, and the rest all 2017 or before. You can see on this lovely graph. That dot right at the bottom is the oldest book I read this year, which was Peril at End House by Agatha Christie, which was first published in 1932. And then the newest book I read this year was A Phoenix First Must Burn, which was published in March. And then finally, my last statistic is the most popular book I read this year, which was Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas. That does not surprise me. It has over 620,000 ratings on Goodreads. And the least popular book, according to Goodreads anyway, was again A Phoenix First Must Burn. Maybe because it was like published most recently, but also because I would say it's underrated and I think more people should read it. But that one has just over 1,000 ratings. So those are all of my statistics for my 2020 reading. Hope it was interesting. I had a lot of fun at least compiling the stats for this video. And it's already given me lots more ideas of more things to track for my 2021 reading. So I will see you in my next video, which will hopefully, fingers crossed, be up the day after this. And that's going to be me talking about like my favourite and least favourite books of 2020. So like the more subjective side to things. But basically, I've had a really good time reading this year. I finally hit 40 books again after not reading very much in 2018 and 2019. And to have an average rating of like 3.5 stars is, I think, proof that I'm actually picking mostly books that I do enjoy, with a couple of notable like duds towards the end of this year, but that's fine. So I will see you in that next video. Bye!